Hi everyone, good morning. This is our first video in Job Control Language, JCL. JCL is nothing but a scripting language that is used for executing your program. So irrespective of whatever the language you are working or database you are using, when it is coming for execution of your program, you need to have a knowledge on JCL. But JCL is very simple and straightforward language, and if you know three statements like job, exec, DD and how to code it, you are good to run your program using JCL. Before seeing them in detail, I'll talk about something about the application development. Okay, the application development is, let's take a simple process here. There is one extraction program, an update program and reporting program. These three programs together form a particular business process. And if there are a number of processes, form basically one application. Okay, so in this process, the whole process we call as a job, and in that every program we call as exec, and every program will have a number of inputs and outputs that we call as a DD. So job is nothing but a high level grouping which is defining the unit of work, and exec is nothing but a program. So one job contain a number of programs, and every program will have a number of DD statements. The DD is meant for files. Okay, so all we need to learn now is what are the parameters and how to code this job exec DD so that we can code it and get it executed. Okay, so now assume that we have coded the job, then what we will do? We will submit the job because it has to get processed, right? It has to get executed. So using job submit statement, we will submit it. Once you submit it, it will be look for any errors, like, you know, syntax checks or something like that. And if there are no errors, it will be going for a processing. Jest will take care of processing. The Jest is job entry subsystem. It is a component in MES operating system, and there are two commonly used, Jest2 and Jest3. Jest2 is a decentralized environment, Jest3 is a centralized environment, and all the installation I worked till date are using only Jest2. Okay. Main difference between these two is, as I already said, Jest2 is like, you know, if five processors are there, all the five will be, you know, parallelly working. In case of Jest3, there will be one processor, is a global processor that receives the jobs and it will route it to other processor based on the workload and availability. Okay, that is centralized. Jest2 is a decentralized. Okay, now what the job Jest will do? It will, if a number of jobs are coming, it will prioritize the job, which one to be executed first, which one is next. Like this, it will prioritize. Once it's prioritized, it schedules, and then it will get executed, and the outputs will be sent. Okay, in the spool or wherever it needs to be routed. So this is about your coding a job and submitting and processing. This is a flow. Now we'll see the coding sheet alone in this video. How the coding sheet of JCL looks. The first two characters contain //, and your 3rd to 10 character contain the name of the operation. If it is a job, it is a job name. If it is a exec, it is a step name. If it is a DD, it is a dataset name. So this is the name of the operation, and then between, starting at 11, the job or exec or DD will be coding. Honestly speaking, you need to have a space between the name and the operation. Leave one space and then you can code it. So after the job, give one space, and then you can do the coding of your parameters associated with the job. Okay, we start, this is a 16th position. Okay, so 72nd, you can code it, 1 to 71, and then if you need to continue, you end this end the statement with a comma, and the next line anywhere between 4 to 16 you can start the next parameters of a particular operation. So first two columns, as I already said, is going to contain //, and if only // is there in a line, that is saying end of job. Okay, after that whatever you put it, that will be ignored. So this indicate end of a job, and /** is used for comments. So comments cannot be continued. If you want to write 5 lines of comments, all the 5 lines, first 3 characters will be /*. Okay. /*, we will see down the line when we talk on in-stream data or control statements. It indicates the end of data or just control statements like route and other commands. Okay, I think and regarding this name used, you know, there is a convention is that naming convention rules are it has to be 8 characters maximum, and it can contain alphabetic, numeric and national characters, and first character should be either alphabetic or national. And I didn't say about PROC, to briefly say what is PROC is. PROC is not something like a subprogram. See, you code a program, what you will do? Your functionality is repeated in n number of programs. You code a subprogram and you call it from there. The advantage is later a change needs to be done. You can do it in a subprogram instead of coding in all the programs that calls a subprogram. Okay. So that's a reusability, right? The same way, if you want, you know, one program or set of programs together executed in multiple jobs, you separate from the job stream as a procedure and invoke here as a procedure. So later a change, one input is changed, you no need to change all the jobs. Since it is externalized now, only making the change in the procedure is good enough. You know, it will reduce a lot of work. So that is what procedure, and we will see how to code a procedure in stream, extreme, all those things we will see down there in videos. I think as part of introduction, whatever I want to say, have said in this video, and maybe I hope to complete, you know, this JSON topic in 7 to 8 videos, and our next videos onwards is going to be completely hands-on. Okay. Thanks for watching.